a small book that's called The Greatest Miracle in the World by Og Mandino. It was life-changing for me. But I think that almost any book, any song, any major event that happens in our lives is kind of a wake-up call if we're just paying attention. And that's God trying to get our attention and to show us that He's there. And we have to be ready and receptive to hear that and for that to be a possible life-changing event in our lives. So I think maybe that's the moment when God actually speaks to you and you have to be ready to listen. So that's what happened for me. So I like that idea that God is always around all the time, everything that we do. And all we have to do is just pay attention and kind of notice the little things. And the Bible calls that the old seek, knock, search, and find message in the Bible. So anyway, the thing about this tiny book that was so powerful for me is it simplifies and boils down the message of the Bible into four easy steps. So the four easy steps are count your blessings, proclaim your rarity, go another mile, and use wisely your power to choose. So of course, these steps aren't easy. As anyone who lives and breathes knows, life can be a flat beatdown at times. The highs and lows can be treacherous. There can be swings. None of us are excluded from all of that. So, which brings me to the point of this message. Choosing to invest time in the Word and investing in others. So we're going to skip the first three steps, the easy steps of this book, and get down to choice. Choosing wisely. So choose to spend your time working on bettering yourself first. So work on things that help you mentally, physically, spiritually. And this is the best investment we ever make. As we study and pray and wonder what all this means, we actually are doubly blessed if we join a small group, and a group of like-minded people that help us to stay on the path and figure out what all this really means. So all of us are relational, and we need others to help clarify our thinking and keep us on that right path. So surround yourself with friends to do this at the highest level. Choose to love rather than hate. Choose to laugh rather than cry. Choose to create rather than destroy. Choose to persevere rather than quit. Choose to praise rather than gossip. Choose to heal rather than wound. Choose to give rather than steal. To act rather than procrastinate. To grow rather than rot. Choose to pray rather than curse. And choose to live rather than die. The keys to a meaningful, fulfilled life are here in this book. However, this book, as good as it is just the cliff notes. You don't want the cliff notes to actually be your book that you live by and that you surround all the ones that you love and pattern your life about. So we want to turn to study of the real book, God's Word. So the keys to a meaningful, fulfilled life are here in this book. Study it like your life and the life of the ones you love most depend on it. Invest your time where it matters most. Choose love. It's life-changing.